This is the Dark One's Closet with your host, Death.
It's Brittany, bitch.
Hey, boys and girls. It's your good old friend Death here. This week's episode had a corpse of skeleton. So I hope you enjoy.
Look, I know the supernatural is something that isn't supposed to happen, but it does happen.
Say, kids, what time is it?
Corpse and a skeleton. What you need. Skeleton. Rags. Stain. Red. Brown. Can of foam. Gloves. Plastic. Scissors. Screwdriver to open this. Heat gun. Heat gun's a big must. Alright, let's get started. So, first thing, get your plastic out. And what I like to do is to cut to measure. About good enough. You don't really need the whole thing, so should be there. Some people turn around and tape it down. I don't, I just wrap it. That should be good. Now, take our heat gun. Mind you, this is pretty hot. Alright, one leg done. Leg done. Move on to an arm. Now I can do the other leg. as you can see, doesn't have to be perfect. Here, gag. Right now I'm just cutting little pieces to fix little spots here and there.
Thank you. Got a bald spot. Pretty much look good. Now see, this, right here, lips. Should be good. Now the reason why I left this open is because I'm gonna fill it with foam. That will give it the guts. Which actually looks pretty cool. Let's make sure we have enough of this to cover it. Yes we do. Hands look good. Toes. Rest of the body. Alright. Foam, fill it for cracks. Stuff stinks. I don't know how well the inside will dry, but eh. Alright, so now it's just let her dry and we'll come back in a few. Alright, good. Dried. A little gooey, but we can still work with it. Look at that. Test times. Woo! Now we go for the red. Gloves, because I don't want this crap in my hands. Thank you. probably should have grabbed a paintbrush too. Most time, I actually do take a little paintbrush and I go in and I paint the dark colors in there. But this time, we're going to put skin over his intestines. So we're not trying to be too perfect. Just enough to get up in there. Red is done. I would say so. Good. Solid. Good. Now, I gave him a little bit of skin. Look at that. Nice little insides. Kind of drooping. Let's see if we can get some of those ribs really pop. Gruesome. I like that. All right, let's move on to the good, more of the corpse look. You know? He doesn't have a little winky. Oh well, his bad. So it doesn't have to be totally perfect. Just enough to give it that dead look. A lot of people turn around and just put it on and wipe it off right away. I think it looks kind of cool, not. But that's just my opinion. I think at times having a little bit of darker spots here and there gives it that more of a character look. Not too worried about the bottom of the feet because, well, nobody ever sees them. Alright. So I missed a spot. No big deal. We'll just call that hanging flesh. There's no right, way or wrong way to really do this. And that. And that's how you corpse a skeleton. If you want to see more details, like what I do up in here with painting it and putting lips and spray painting the eyes and darkening it a little bit and stuff, leave a comment in the, down below, and I'll throw another video up and I'll show you all the little other little bits I do. But otherwise, this is pretty much how you corpse a skeleton. Oh, one last thing, what I learned. Once this is dry, it's still gonna be tacky. Baby powder is your friend. Throw a bunch of baby powder on it, it'll take care of all the stickiness away, and he won't smell and all that stuff, and he won't be sticking to your hand still. So, that's it.